Actually, I think I know four ways to construct abelian varieties in any characteristic. The first one is just to write down an equation. But this works only for plane elliptic curves. The second one is yes, constructing, this is equations, okay. Abelian varieties. Well, for high dimensions, this works not so good. But that's too difficult. Geometry. I mean, you can take a curve and it's Jacobian. Or a prim variety of a double covering. Or actually for a smooth projective variety, you have a peak zero. And usually it is an abelian variety. In any characteristic. In any characteristic. The reduction is, yeah, thank you. So the third one is if the ground field is C, then we can take that's an analytic way over C. So we can take a quotient by a lattice. And this will be an abelian variety if I have a Riemann form. And today I'm going to speak about the first way, the fourth way. It works over FQ, and it is called Honda-Tate theorem. For now, I just say that if we are going to construct an abelian variety, we should start with an algebraic number, which is called Weyl number. And this number will, starting from this number, we can construct an isogeny class of abelian varieties. Actually, in these three cases, we get a single abelian variety from our data. And here we have just an isogeny class. That's the main difference. Actually, this is very important for many applications. So let me recall that abelian variety is a group and a projective variety at the same time. So isogeny of abelian varieties is a map, say, from A to B, which is surjective finite homomorphism. Of my abelian varieties. And I need two main examples of isogenies. First, if we have a natural number, actually an integral number, then the multiplication by n gives an isogeny from A to A. And, I should say that since this map is finite, I can define degree. It's the degree of this map. So the degree of my n is n to the power 2 dimension A. If P does not divide n, and actually we can compute the kernel of this isogeny.
It's also wrong, right? Even if P does divide n.
What?
Even if P does divide n.
Oh, sorry, I wanted to write it here about the kernel. Thank you. The set of points, the group of points in the kernel is isomorphic to Z divided by Zm to the power to dimension A if P does not divide M. That's the point. And in general, there could be there is an isogeny for which the degrees is greater than one, and the group of points is zero. This is called Frobenius. Group of points of the kernel is zero. So I believe everybody knows that, but I just to stress that this is an isogeny, and I need the one which is identity. There are many Frobeniuses. Identity on schematic points and acts on the functions. So f goes to the f to the q. Where f q, yes, from now on, and actually from the very beginning, from now on, okay. K is f q, and this is the q. Its degree is q, and its kernel is just something complicated. This is not important. I just want to say that there are no points here. Okay. There is an easy but important proposition on isogenies, that if I have an isogeny from A to B, say phi, then I can multiply by the degree of phi, and there exists some isogeny psi, which makes this triangle commutative. And from this proposition, it follows that that being isogeneous is an equivalence relation. So A is isogeneous to B. This thing is an equivalence relation. So it is correct to speak about isogeny classes, the set of abelian varieties, which are, any two of them are isogeneous. Okay, now I would like to give one more definition. The Tate module of A is defined by the limit of the groups A of L to the M k bar points. Here I fix some prime number L, which is P. And we have a Frobenius section on this group. Moreover, my first proposition that the first, well, from this description of the kernel, we know that this group is isomorphic to the is a free Zetel module of rank two dimension of A. And Frobenius acts linearly on the Tate module. So I can define a characteristic polynomial of this section. And this is called Feil polynomial. And this, well, this is L. Not E, but L. And this Feil polynomial is the object I will use to classify my isogeny classes, actually. There's a theorem by Weyl, I believe, that this polynomial has integral coefficients. And moreover, for any root pi of fa, it's an algebraic number, complex number, so its absolute value is square root of q. So it is called a Riemann hypothesis for abelian varieties over fq. In general, that was proved by Deligne for any varieties. So the contribution of Tate to this theory was that this action I just introduced, the action of Frobenius on the Tate module, is semi-simple. This is the first one. And the second one is that FA equals to FB for some abelian varieties F and B, if and only if A and B are isogeneous. So in fact, this is enough to give a kind of classification of abelian varieties. This is not a real corollary, really a statement that my isogeny classes of abelian varieties is in one-to-one correspondence with Weyl polynomials. This is not actually a statement because I didn't define this set independently from the left side. So
is the real statement that the net from isogeny classes to polynomials is injective?
Yes, for example. That's the statement, but it's not it's good, but it's not so important. But actually that's what Tate proved originally. What? Yes, that's the goal of my talk, actually, yes, to give a characterization of this set. But I just would like to say that at this point we have such a pre-theorem. And this, actually, you may forget about this so far and just remember all these statements. I would like to prove a proposition which I always use we'll use tomorrow. Sorry.
Did you prove that two things are isogenous?
You mean this?
Yes.
Well, that's the theory. Tate was not a stupid guy.
Yeah, I know.
this theorem is very non-trivial, yeah. It's, you're right, that it is...
The question of how you, of what you started with, you said that you can construct for editors in several ways, yes?
Yeah.
So over here there's also...
Yes, I would like to go from... to the other direction. So I should take a polynomial of special sort, and then from this polynomial I would like to get an isogeny class. So far I can do that because I have to start with a polynomial which comes from an abelian variety. This is not my goal. Yeah, but I just want to say that Anton is right that it is. It's not hard to understand that if A and B are isogenies, then the way polynomials are equal because we have this isomorphic Galois representations. Okay, so the proposition. Suppose F is a Weyl polynomial. So far, this just means there exists A such that FA is F and nothing more. And suppose T is a free Littell module. It is some action which I call F auction with F. Such that its characteristic polynomial is F. And additionally, which is important, the section is semi-simple. On the corresponding vector space. Then there exists an abelian variety B isogeneous to A such that T is actually the Lth Tate module of B. So actually, this proposition allows one to construct an abelian variety with some special properties with a given Tate module, actually, starting from a Weyl polynomial and just some action. Okay, you just see it. And the proof. I'll give you the proof just to show how that theorems could be applied. Okay, first let me just say it again that if I have an isogeny, any isogeny from A to B, then the induced map on the Tate modules is an isogeny again. That means that, well, there's an isomorphism tensor Q. I would like to inverse this construction, so I take, since I have an isomorphism T times Q to TL of A times Q, that's why I need this A, then from this isomorphism, I can construct, just multiplying it by a power of L, an injective map to TL of A, and I claim that this quotient, it is finite. The map is F equivariant. So there is a finite groove with Frobenius section, which is the quotient of a Tate module. That means that it corresponds to a finite group in finite group scheme actually in A. I should explain it. When I say group scheme in this situation, I just mean that there is a finite group with some Frobenius section, and that's the way to define a group, an Étale group scheme over a finite field, actually. So that's the only meaning of the word group scheme. And now B can be defined as a quotient. It is known that Abelian variety can be divided by such a G. Yes, because E L is not P and so on. So that's the construction. L is not P, it's not possible. No. I just forget about this. I have an isomorphism which comes from the fact that I have a semi-simple linear operator such that its characteristic polynomial is a well polynomial. That's why I have such an isomorphism, and from this I can produce an F equivariant injection to the Tate module. And the order of this quotient is power of L. So indeed this is an Étale group scheme. Okay. Okay, so now I would like to define this set of L polynomials. First of all, the category of abelian varieties up to isogeny is semi-simple, and this means that Home sets, home groups from A to B is defined as just by tensoring with Q. And home means the set of isogenies from A to B. So in particular, any abelian variety up to isogeny can be is isomorphic, or is isogeneous to a product of simple abelian varieties. That's my next definition. It is simple if, just from this definition, if for any subvariety B, B is either 0 or A.
And B is either 0 or B is isogeneous
to B. But it's a subvariety. And no, that's the definition. So I would like to reduce my problem to simple abelian varieties. And for that I need the following theorem, that first think that just because of the category is semi-simple, the endomorphism algebra, which is by definition home from A to A, is a division algebra if A is simple. And moreover, we know the center of this algebra. It is generated by Frobenius. So in particular, if the polynomial the if A is simple, then its real polynomial is a power of irreducible polynomial with integral coefficients. Who knows how to prove it? This is because the center of the endomorphism algebra is Q of F, and it is since the action of F is simple, we can let P for a moment, PA, be a minimal polynomial of F. Then this polynomial is separable, and this algebra, it's Q of T divided by P of T. And if this polynomial is reducible, this algebra is the sum of at least two other algebras to something or sum, as you wish. I think sum is better because from this you see that you can take identity element in this algebra and it gives you a projector. It's just a product of commutative algebras, yeah, it's over Q. Yeah. But identity element of this algebra gives you a projector which splits your variety, so this is impossible. In particular, I can define here. I'm going to define the real number is a root. Real number is the root of this irreducible polynomial. Actually, but there is a. Now I have an independent definition, real number pi in Q bar is a number such that. Is a number such that for any embedding from the field generated by pi to C, say sigma, the module of sigma of pi is the square root of Q. So in other words, P is uniquely defined by my reducible polynomial, and I just want to that for any root of this polynomial, the Riemann hypothesis holds. Yeah. I claim this is enough. So I have a second corollary, which is a statement that there is a map from the set of isogeny classes of abelian varieties to well numbers up to Gla action. Thank you. Of simple abelian varieties. Yeah. That's important. So the claim is that's the Tate-Honda theorem that this map is bijective. Say TH. TH is bijective. And actually, I would like to.
Wait, it's a corollary of what? Everything that is written as a corollary.
Corollary of corollaries. As everything is simple, and this is not simple, that's why it's theory.
No, but maybe another question is, what is the statement of the last corollary? No, this one.
There is an injective map. This map is injective, yeah. Thank you. The statement is that the map is injective. Actually, this is well defined and injective. That's the statement. Okay, so. Actually, this is not a statement. It is still not the same as this one, because I don't have a way to produce a well polynomial from a well number. By this I mean that I know this irreducible polynomial p, but somehow I should define this number e. And in fact, for some, I will give examples right now, that it is possible that not any e can appear in this formula for Fell polynomials. So I would like to define e from the starting from the Well number. So e. Is the least common multiple of the numbers EV, where V is either R or V lies over P. And actually to define EV, I would like to define the invariant. It's the same. Define the invariant at V. V is evaluation of P. Of the endomorphism algebra of my A. Yeah.
What is the little V?
V is evaluation
of what?
Of Q bar.
Of Q bar.
Okay, QP bar. Okay. Okay, you're right. Let me write down the formula, and then you will. Yeah, thank you. I should write down the formula first. So, I would like to define this number. So this algebra is a division algebra with center Q of F. So. So we have this field and the evaluation of this field. Over QP, that's not F but pi. That's the same field, but I'm starting from pi. So I take evaluation of this field and write down the following formula. Thank you. So V goes through evaluations of V is evaluation of Q of pi.
So V is not R, but it's a real place above.
V could be R. If it is evaluation, that it could be R.
It's more than one real place, right?
It's I should define ER. What? So ER is one if pi is not real, and two if it is real.
Yeah, but so point is a priori that's not well defined. It depends on your complex embedding. Field Q pi has several places of real numbers, and some can be real, some can be complex.
V is a real embedding. What do you want from me? V is real. Is it okay? Да, их может быть несколько. Okay, so that's the statement. To any real embedding. If well, actually, I'm talking about the set of such numbers. And well, if I have several numbers two, that's not dangerous for me. one is enough. And now this is not a corollary. It's actually a statement that I have such bijection. And well, polynomials are defined in that way that I have several well numbers, I have several numbers E which satisfy something. And that's the Weyl polynomial. And starting from this Weyl polynomial, I can construct an isogeny class of abelian varieties. So let me give you some examples of this Weyl polynomials and Weyl numbers. So the first one is that actually well, numbers could be real, and if you take pi is plus or minus square root of q, this is real. And we have two cases here. If the square root is integral, then well, this p a is actually of t is t minus plus or minus square root of q, and that means my e is 2 because of this formula. So that's the Weyl polynomial, and this Weyl polynomial corresponds to the isogeny class of supersingular elliptic curves. But now if this square root of q is not integral, then my Weyl polynomial is actually the same as the same as p, so it's t square minus q. Oops, I'm wrong. This is p, and this polynomial could not be a Weyl polynomial because, well, it has wrong sign in front of q. And by the same reason, because e is 2, sorry, fa is the square of this polynomial, and actually we are talking about abelian surfaces now. Okay, that's the only way the Weyl number could be real. So now I assume that, from now on, I assume that the Weyl number is not real, first of all. So ER is 1, and from now on, I just think about the primes which lie over P. So assume my p is of the form t square minus bt plus q, where b is integral. And from the Riemann hypothesis, I have an additional restriction that since b is a trace of pi, so it's pi plus q over pi. So it's not greater of 2 square root of q. And fortunately, that's the condition on b, on the polynomial to be a minimal. Thank you. That's the condition on b, and on the polynomial p, on from this condition, it follows that the root of this pi is a Weyl number. Actually, let me state it. If b is not greater than 2 square root of q, then a root of p is a Weyl number. So assume that p does not divide b. Then it's not hard to see that over qp this polynomial is a product of two linear ones. So p has two roots in qp because of the Genzel lemma. And v of p1 is 0, say, or v of p2 is the same as v of q. So that's the case of ordinary elliptic curve. I think you can compute everything you want, the morphism algebra and so on, from these computations. Now I would like to Okay, I have erased this. So let me give a more interesting example. This was not two, but just a new example. So relation of B is positive, but less than relation of Q divided by 2. In this case, E E can be computed as it's relation of Q divided by greatest common divisor of relation of Q, relation of P1, relation of P, and relation of Q divided by P. And because of this relation, this number is always greater than 1. So we have an isogeny class of abelian varieties of dimension greater than 1. That's the that's the example. And finally, relation of B is greater or equal to relation of Q divided by 2. And how much time do I have? 3 minutes. Okay, sorry. Okay, from this relation we get that B square is not greater than 4Q. But at the same time, this inequality B square is greater or equal. So, but because of this, actually we have five possibilities. B is zero, Q is B square, 2Q is B square, 3Q is B square, and 4Q is B square. 4Q. Yeah, just because of this. Sorry. Okay, so I don't have time for this, but actually, if you just come through all these five cases, you will prove what is known the Doring theorem. So that gives a classification of. Isogeny classes of elliptic curves. Because often, but not all the time, but for most Q, this number E will be 1, and we get an isogeny class of elliptic curves. Okay, so since I don't have time for some more details, I should stop here.
So, any questions? Comments? Let's thank the class again. So, instead of today, we'll meet here at 3:30 tomorrow.
stuff.